How the Evil Win. The origin of evil in myths almost always involves a penance. Penance for immortality. One of great tenacity that's rooted in greed and an ego that one can never fully feed. Like all the stories, the creator appears, not too soon, to grant them the boon, thus bending to their whim that never a man, and never ever a woman would slay them. This is where the story blips. The reality gets rheumatized. For the creator, he discounted the power of our infinite capacity for hate. That would warp all plot points and rewrite the etched out fate. Even now the penance continues. The boons get answered. And as they go about their plunders, the creator weeps. The creator weeps over his blunders. All the folks who are sent to bring this misery to an end are trapped. Are trapped in the brackets of gender, clutching onto the little strength that their minds would measuringly render. In a world numb to nuance, they become songs in a broken cassette. Unheard, unloved, and never understood. Locked up in a corner of some dingy closet. This is how the evil wins. They spin up a story with no ending, with heroes draped in a fabricated sin. Made to walk barefoot in a road so rough, reminded every day that they are incomplete and can never be full enough. When you were born again, you asked me for a name. I named you after your smile, the one that you stole from an infant. When you were born again, you stripped down all the coats you wore. Coats of single colors, of black and white and everything between. As you had grown out of them, or as they never felt right anymore. Then you cut them up and stitched them up into a coat of many colors. Then you cut them up and stitched them into a coat of many colors. Like a story from the Bible that you never read, or from that country song you never heard. When the needle sometimes went beneath your skin and returned leaving a mark, I hope you were able to bear the pain as you yearned for that fresh start. As you walk every day with that coat on a ramp that you never chose, blind to the judging camera flashes, deaf to the noises that rose. I wish one day you'd remove it for me. I wish one day you'd remove it for me so that I can tend to the wounds they hide. And then I'll put the coat back on for you. Make some tea, share a smoke or two before I take you out on a ride. And keep letting you know that always I shall be there by your side. When she spoke to me about nostalgia and the idea of a non-existent past and how the aspirations last as long as the memory lasts, she told me the brackets that we are forced upon to live. I listened to her story, but I had no words to give. You see, my typewriter, it's still one of those old machineries manipulated by strange fingers that still sees the world in black and white. But that day, when we parted, we agreed to work for a future. To work for a future where even the typewriters bleed rainbow memories. We agreed to work for a future where even the typewriters bleed rainbow memories.